Hi guys, I'm back. I didn't go away. Like you see from the previous video, this is just a continuation. It's not another day, it's still the same day. Just continuing with a few other points. So if you're new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe and just watch other videos as well. Watch the part one of this video. I hope you like it and you learn a thing or two from here. So where was I? So last week I was sharing a few points of what I learned. Not last week, a few days ago. What I've learned about on my journey as a mother, and just things I didn't expect, or things I wish that I was told, and I shared a few. So I'm just continuing with the last bit. So one of the other things I must say is that, you know, I ended talking about unsolicited advice, I think, from the previous video. This one I want to say is that I was very surprised that a lot of negative comments or judgments that people get, women get in general, are from other women or other mothers. Not even necessarily me, but just hearing from, like, let me say, for example, some people make comments about how I changed back drastically postpartum, like, oh, ndo washona kone, whatever, you know, like, I look not pregnant anymore. But what I was very shocked to see is that they would use other women as examples, and I hate that. Personally, I don't like that. Don't tell me, oh wow, you look so good, Justin, Justina doesn't look like that, you know. I don't like that. If you're gonna compliment me, compliment me and keep it moving. Don't judge another mother. You don't know what they're going through. Don't be telling me, oh, your child is not wearing diapers anymore. Nay, that's good. Whose child is still in diapers and they are older than him or her? Don't do that. Let's not do that. Let's stop being negative to each other. If you're going to encourage someone, you're going to compliment someone, do it and leave someone else out there. Especially when it comes to weight. People are struggling with so much. I once made a video about postpartum body, pregnancy shaming. Pregnancy weight shaming, postpartum shaming, all these things, and I deleted it. But I think I'll probably talk about it in another day. I personally really don't like it. I was doing a survey where I was asking a few of my family and friends, what are the worst comments or worst things that people said to you during pregnancy? And I realized that people are just mean, and I don't like that. Let's just be kind to each other. We don't know what people are struggling with. Don't expect a woman to go on a diet and she's breastfeeding. You don't understand how many calories that she needs, how much energy she needs, how much food she needs to take in just to feed that child. So please, let's not do that. Mothers, stop judging other mothers. Can we not? And yeah, so the other thing is, don't compare your weight, okay, back to this point, don't compare your weight or your baby's weight or your baby's milestones to someone else. Same point is what I was talking about before. Leave people and their journeys alone. Don't compare. Don't say, your child is already sitting. Whose child is not sitting yet? Don't do that. Oh, who gave birth to a child that is so big? Me, my child was just what? Don't do that. Like, and then what? My child was 5 kgs, yours was 2 kgs. And then what? What Nobel Prize did you win? Nothing. So please, let's not do that. You don't even understand, what that woman is struggling with. Like, there's just so many things that the person is struggling with already, and you are here telling them about how their baby is so big or their baby is not small. Imagine someone asking you, like, it's a newborn. How can I not be feeding my child? Don't be telling me my child is too small, like I'm not feeding them. I'm feeding the child. And also don't be telling me I'm overfeeding my child, because I'm only giving them breast milk. It's not my fault if my milk is rich. Okay, this is me now. Yeah, like, just me, like, my boy is big. No, he is. He's not obese or anything, but he is a chubby baby. And I love that, because I had a list of things I wanted for my baby, and I really wanted a chubby baby because I just think they're cute and, like, cuddly, and, you know, when they hold on to you, like, yeah. So, and I'm not, and I love that, because it doesn't worry me, because I'm giving breast milk. It's not like you're saying I'm feeding the child pizzas and burgers and what. No, I'm not doing that. So let's not do that, guys. If I tell you that who gave birth to a child and the child is 4 kg, oh my God, what was she eating in pregnancy? What were you eating? What were you not eating? Ne? Don't do that, guys. Some things are genetic and it really doesn't, I don't know why, what we gain from being negative like that. I don't like it. So me, don't come to me comparing someone's child or someone's weight to other people's and other, like, yo, let me not even find you compare my child to somebody. Hey, no. But yeah, growth spurt is another thing that I didn't expect. I didn't know it was even a thing. Growth spurt is that time where it lasts about sometimes 2 days, sometimes a week, where your child is just feeding a lot. They're feeding a lot and they're sometimes they're extra clingy, all these things. They're going through a growth spurt, like they're growing a lot. I think the word is self-explanatory in that time. So just bear with it. I remember one of the weeks, like recently, my child was going through that. And I almost just lost it because I was waking up every hour to feed him. And I'm like, hi, I was exhausted. But then also, the doctor said that for him, because of now, like his weight and everything, and his 4 months, it means he's ready to feed. So let us just start him on... and solids once a day. So I started him and luckily, like, yeah, the process has been so much better. But it was a lot for me, like waking up every hour to feed. I'm like, what is going on? And he just wants to be held, just wants to be with me, which was so weird because he normally just wants to, he's an independent baby, just wants to be there unless he wants something from you. It's a not an easy time, but it passes. I know there's a 3-6-9 rule, ne? It happens usually at week 3, week 6, week 9, month 3, month 6, month 9. Like those, it's not exactly or precise. It can, there's a range. But I do remember for my son, like, I would see him going through that. And then I remember what week he's in. I remember, like, month 3 now was when I was going through it. And I'm just like, yo, what's going on? But yeah, so once you know and you're prepared and you know, like, it's just a phase and everything that happens to me with a child or even just with me, even when I was in pain, I always tell myself it's temporary. It's going to pass. I'm going to just deal with this. It's going to pass. Nothing can compare to the joy of having this child. It's going to pass. And anyone who's feeling the opposite, there's also nothing wrong with that. But if you just try and encourage yourself, it is going to pass. You will heal. Really, you will heal. And vaccination day is the worst. Seeing your child look at you with that look of betrayal. Heck, mommy, why did you let them do this to me? From him, he cries when they put in the injection and everything. And then he cries a little bit after that. And then he's okay. But I remember the first vaccination. Every time he would flex his leg, like bend, he would cry. And also the third injection was also really, he got swollen and what. He really tried to be tough, this child, but I could tell which are no men. So it's not easy. I feel like if a mother can even get a day or two off from work after vaccination day, it would really help because the child just wants to be held, extra fussy, they have a fever, all these things. So I didn't expect that. I remember that night, the first vaccination, Phil was up like the whole night just feeling him, baby's warm, baby's warm, baby's warm. And I'm like, yes, babe, it's expected. It did get better. It wasn't warm to the point where I was too worried, but it did eventually go down. And yeah, so it happens. Baby go through that. We were advised to be applying castor oil after every diaper change, the 100% castor oil after every diaper change. Give paracetamol if you can. Keep the child cool, but like, yeah, just be there. Like it, like I said, it's temporary. Your child will be fine. Usually by the next day they are fine. But if you can see that it's really not going well, this like reacting badly, take the child to the hospital. It's better for you to be told, don't worry, it's normal, than for you to just be home and telling yourself, no, it's normal. No, sometimes it's not normal. So do what's best for you and your child. One thing I also don't like that I didn't expect is some negative comments like, you know, my son loves water. He loves being in the water. He cries when you take him out of the water. And then someone would be like, oh, he likes water now. He likes to be bathed. What? You are telling me because my child likes to be bathed now, it means he's not going to like to be bathed later. Okama, because he likes laughing a lot now, like now because he loves laughing and smiling, you hardly hear him crying. Kama, it's not going to like people. I'm just like, and you people get these things from where? Like, fine, maybe there's some level of experience that happens there, but just don't be saying, I just don't. Like, if you don't have anything to say, just leave it. Leave. What was that, Alina? Okay, I was itchy. No, I don't like those things. Just leave it, okay? What else? I don't think I'm done, hey? Oh yes, one of my favorite things. Oh no, the other thing is, you and your partner will disagree over the baby. I remember the first disagreement my husband and I had over the baby. Not like, it wasn't a fight, I'm saying disagreement, because it was about water temperature. Me, generally, I'm someone that loves very hot water when I bath. We already don't agree on water temperature, like with our own bodies. Now, this is with a child. He was like, no, the water is too hot. And I'm like, no, the water is okay. I even went as far as I took the thermometer, and I'm like, the water is okay. And I'm like, you're going to get the child feeling cold. And he's like, no, you're going to burn the child. And yo, it was just hectic. If you can get a water thermometer, get that so that you can avoid such disagreements in your home. But I don't have one. I just use a normal thermometer, which I don't think is accurate. But anyways, in the end, he does more of the washing of the child. When he washes, sometimes I just sit there, because sometimes, like, we would be, applying lotion on the arms, he's applying on the legs, I'm putting the child's top, it was too much, like this tiny person having two adults around, it was too much. So I decided to give it up and allow him to just do it and take over, because it wasn't working. It was not working. But just so many different things, man, like you will disagree on some things, like, can you do this? The child is this. Like, no, the child wants to feed, and I just fed the child. Or, yeah, it's usually not big things, but it's just, they happen. They are normal, but don't neglect each other. That's one thing that me and my partner always try and talk about, that let's try and make time for each other, even if it means watching something when he's sleeping. But it's very important for you guys to just get that moment of bonding again, because it can easily become about the child. I remember there was a night we were sleeping, and I was just like, I wanted this man to go sleep in our bedroom, because we were sleeping in the baby's room, because I just felt like he's not turning properly, like he's turning like burgutu burgutu, like turn gently, like there's another person on the bed, like you're gonna wake up the child and I must now put him to sleep. Or I feel like he's forgetting that there's a child and then he's just sleeping. So it's like I'm looking at him and I'm just like, to hit you with a pillow, you get. So it happens, it really happens, but give each other grace. That's another way where, oh, I'll get to that when I finish. But the last thing I wanted to say was that I heard, or I found out, that apparently unoni haukwatwa omnukunasha. Yeah, like every time someone comes to see the child, or I'm around somewhere and then the child person is meeting the child, before they touch the child, sometimes they'll be like, oh, I and them peshoka niyaka inakapewasha. So they'll take out money and give you. Or when they come and visit the child, they bring a gift. And I'm just like, okay. And then one day when I went to my previous hospital, Konanjokwe, sister Johanna, shout out to Sister Shibute, she went in her office and then she went to get money and then she gives the child and she's like, I unoni hakuatuntu kunasha. I was like, wow, I really didn't know that. Like, it was actually a thing. I just used to think people are just generous. Or maybe it is just generosity. Because, I mean, yeah, there are people that have seen the child that didn't give the child something. But I think that's pretty cool, hey? But I think I also won't show up to someone's child anymore without anything. I never did before. But I just mean, like, now it's a thing. So, yeah, I think I have covered a lot of the things. Oh, yes, it was just going to be about postpartum depression and postpartum blues. I suffered from postpartum blues. I was afraid of falling into postpartum depression because I've experienced depression before. So there's a difference where sometimes there's a very thin line between the two. What I experienced was I did struggle with sleeping sometimes, especially when my mom left. I had some insomnia issues. Not even because the baby is not sleeping. but just I myself was just struggling to sleep. There was a day my mom was even like, "Are you okay?" I was feeling low, I was feeling down. I didn't understand why. I just wanted to cry. I really didn't understand why. There's just there's a lot. I had a lot of anxiety. Sometimes I was sad, I was emotional, but I was trying to just, I was very aware of it because I didn't want to fall into depression. If you start seeing yourself like you're really not interested, sometimes some people don't even want the child. They don't even want to eat. They don't want to do anything. They don't even want to bath. Sometimes those are just, those are clear telltale signs of depression, postpartum depression. You need to get help. Don't just be there and say like, oh, whatever. And also postpartum depression goes on longer than postpartum blues. Okay, for the sake of trying to not make this video too long, it's already long, I've already shared too much. There's one of the big differences, let me say, between the two is a time frame. Postpartum blues can last up to weeks, and postpartum depression can even go longer to months and even a year or whatever. With postpartum depression also, it can be a bit extreme. There sometimes the symptoms can be way more extreme, including like detachment from the child and things like that. I did have a conversation with a friend about baby dumping and how I think there's a really close relationship between that, and maybe we need to really look into it, because yeah, especially now I think about it a lot more now after I gave birth, that someone to carry their child for 9 months, give birth to them, sometimes maybe even breastfeed them for 2-3 days, and then decide to throw away this child. Maybe this person is not okay. It could be that they're suffering from postpartum depression that just goes undiagnosed. So I really think we really need to look at this and be a bit more sensitive when it comes to some of these things. Postpartum blues don't last as long, and sometimes the symptoms aren't as severe, but it's also something that you can suffer from the blues and fall into the depression. So one really just has to take care of their mental health. You'll be so fatigued, and if you're not getting the rest, it can be very overwhelming. So yeah, if you can get the help, please get the help. Be very aware that those happen. They happen to almost every woman. Most women go through postpartum blues as well, and postpartum depression for some people as well. So yeah, it's good to be aware, and even just those people around you, be aware of these things so you know how to help your loved ones and how to care for them in those moments, how to get them the help. It's very, very important to know this. So I personally experienced baby blues, or postpartum blues as some call them, and I'm glad that I knew that and I was aware of it and I was expecting it. So I was trying to find ways to get myself well rested, eat well. When I was losing my appetite, I'm like, let me, you know, just because I'm aware of it. But it's not something that one can easily just be like, no, let me force myself to eat, let me what. So yeah, don't judge when you find someone is really struggling, even maybe with a child. The other thing is, some women struggle with bonding with a child. Doesn't mean it's postpartum depression, but sometimes people just don't struggle instantly with their child, and there's nothing wrong with that. It happens to the better, to the best of us. So just be aware, read up more in the fourth trimester what happens, so that you don't think like you're abnormal or like you are weird or you are whatever, you are a bad mother or whatever. No, be prepared, read up on it, educate the people close to you who are people who are close to people who are pregnant or have babies. Educate yourselves as well so you can know how to better care for these people. But yeah, I think for me that is it for today. I am just going to end it by saying that give yourself grace. It's not something you've done before, especially if you're a new mother. Give yourself grace. Give yourself patience. Be kind to yourself. Don't beat yourself up. People are going to judge you, but don't judge yourself. Even things like, oh my God, I'm so fat, or I'm so wild, the weight is not going. You use that body to carry a whole human being. You use that body to bring your child into this world, to give your child life. That body did the things, man. Even if you're having stretch marks or whatever, that is a sign of your motherhood. So embrace it, enjoy it. I was even telling my friend someone the other day, I call my C-section my scar of love, because for me, I don't have sensation anymore around where my scar is. Like, I feel it, but I'm not really feeling much. I guess the nerves got damaged in the process. I read about it. Sometimes it can come back, sometimes it doesn't come back, but that's my scar of love. That's the scar that is a daily reminder of the fact that I brought my son into this world. I guess the stretch mark part skipped me so that I can have something else to look at daily. At least, I mean, like in my tummy, that is. So, but I don't even like women bashing themselves or bashing their bodies when it comes to things that have to do with having given birth. Don't force yourself to go to the gym. You are doing just fine. You're taking in all the calories and all the carbs that you're taking in to feed your child. And that is okay, mama. You are doing very well. And yeah, for the new fathers as well, we see you, especially those of you who are very supportive and who are there, we see you, you are doing a good job, you deserve to be applauded. It's not an easy thing, especially if you're a new father as well, it's not an easy thing to deal with a baby and a mother who's also going through different hormones. But keep at it, keep being there for her, keep being the strong support system, and yeah, please keep loving them. I feel like I love my husband way more now when I see him with my child. Just this whole experience. So we see you. We might not tell you every day, but you are doing a really, really good job. So yeah, guys, thank you guys once again for listening to my long, long stories and for tuning in. I hope you like this video. I will be back soon with something else. But yeah, don't forget to turn on that subscribe to... Click on that subscribe button, turn on the notification bell so you know each and every time that I upload a new video. Share, especially with your people that you feel like this is most relevant for. Like, comment, share your experiences, and let's learn from each other. So yeah, so from me, your girl Butterfly, until next time, it is goodbye.